Get this already started. I don't think I want disc wheels for the pretzel. Let's go with the good old Tron. Can't have those socks though. That looks good. Alright. The pretzel. The pretzel. So this might be my last ride of the year. Let's see. Likely, that's what I'm going with. The expectation is that unless by some, I won't say miracle, but it would take some work to be able to ride over the holidays. I just don't know if it's going to happen. So with this being the last ride of the year, and throughout 2021, I was trying to stick to a goal of 100 miles a week, 5,200 miles for the year, and turns out I got in more than that, and I hit that goal in, I think it was October, November. Actually, it was November. And I was thinking, well, I'm 800 miles short of 6,000, which is a nice round number. And I'd also started exert workouts. And somehow, between all of that, doing workouts and thinking I could hit this 600 miles or 800 mile goal for the rest of the year, 400 miles a month. Here I am. 29.4 miles. 29.6 miles. I'll have 6,000. The pretzel is 72 kilometers. So 30 miles. About halfway through, a little bit more than halfway through. Should hit the mark. Pretty exciting. I had planned. See, this is where planning just doesn't work out all the time. I planned on, last year, I finished the year with the Uber pretzel. And so I was thinking today would be a great day to do the mega pretzel and get a metric century and hit my goal. But I ran out of time. Technically, this morning I did the AutoCat chase race from WTRL, That was 24 kilometers, 25. So if I can go a little bit further on this ride, I should hit a metric century throughout the day. Just a little bit of a break in between. I think that counts. Hey, only 70k left. 70 kilometers left. Go by and flash. On the right. Volume for background music. Can't believe I did the Uber Pretzel last year, and so I actually did. I was doing part of that on the Rapa Festive 500, so 500 kilometers in the last week of the year. And I had a couple of big days right at the front, right at the beginning. Fell behind in the middle, and so I was trying to make up distance at the end. And I had one night where nothing else to do. I spent 6.5 hours riding the Uber Pretzel and then some. Actually, did a metric and I was, the extra I did was like, why not just keep going if I have the time and I can turn this metric century into an imperial century and ride 100 miles. So that's what I did. I didn't push myself too hard, but you know, I think I ended up with 102 miles, something like that. And ate a DiGiorno pizza as my reward. Anyway, so I was looking at the Uber as I was picking up this route. A lot of climbing. And I hate climbing. I was even looking at the Pretzel, thinking, maybe I'll do Bigfoot Hills. There's like 600K or 600 kilometers less, or 600 meters less climb. It'd be less painful, but I feel like having a Pretzel at the end of the year, even though I've only done it once, it's tradition now. Maybe I'll save the Mega Pretzel for the end of 2023. Legs are definitely tired. Last couple days have been pretty intense. Last week, actually, I've been putting in a lot of miles. That chase race this morning was pretty intense. I was zoning out, just trying to hang on to the group. And as we came up on the end, completely lost track of where the finish line was, mistimed my sprint. Still super annoyed at that. But means I'll have a low bar 2022. As long as I don't disappoint myself in the first race of 2022, it'll be a better start. I used that better bike split calculator for the Mega. Said it would take 3.5 hours. I can only assume this will take something less than that. Can usually gauge how long something's gonna take by figure. Always average about 20 miles an hour. It's tough with climbs where you're going, you know, half that. And trying to reconcile, you know, the slow up with how fast you're gonna go down. I feel like there's a joke in there somewhere. a better bike split was 3.5 hours on the Mega at 200 watts. I'm not pushing that right now. Just out for a relaxing ride in Watopia. Epic AOM was the first place I interacted with another dirt biker. I think it was because of that interaction. It would have been last, it's the first time I rode the Epic AOM. I had no idea what I was doing. But, I'd seen this dirt jersey and the dirt behind people's names, assumed it was a mountain bike thing. But after that interaction, his name was Sean, I think. Sean McCaffrey? McCaffrey? Anyways, I, after that, joined the found and then joined the dirt Facebook group, and it's been great. Dads and non-dads. Dads outside riding cycles. Dorks, if they're called. Mertz. Mertz. Fun community for sure. I joined the ZRL season earlier this year. First organized cycling on a dirt team. We're the Dirty Diesels, maybe? I think it was the, it's Division One. One of our first races with the team time trial. I've never done before. And I'd only been in Cat B for a couple of months, maybe? Maybe even a month and a half. And, started this team time trial sort of on. Like, I'd watched videos, I knew how it worked in theory. YouTube is great for that. But a Division 1B team time trial, that's your first team time trial ever. Went about as well as you would think. I got caught up in what I understand now. It's the classic yo-yo, or I'd zoom off the front. You know, I was like, ah, it's my turn in the rotation, ramp up super hard, fly off the front, try to hold it, because everybody else is, you know, punching it, trying to catch up with me. Then they catch up, overtake, I'm spent, and I fly off the back. And it only took about 10 minutes of that? No, it's done. It's toast. I stayed away from team time trials for a while. Finally, end of summer. So something about Dirty Watts looking for the team time trial members. I was convinced to give it a non-committal try. And I did better. Honestly, the entire summer I was just that experience and being dropped in a race. One of my first races definitely stung and motivated me to try to get better. I was pretty stoked when I did some more Cat B team time trials. Actually take poles, modulate my power, fly off the back. I've been doing them ever since. Such good, like, just base training. And also to be able to actually chat with people all over the world. I rejoined the ZRL all season. Guess what? Didn't fly off the back on Team Time Trials. Division 4, but still. I have those same kind of memories with playing goalie, ice hockey. Adult hockey. I'm playing up a division, getting smoked. Feeling just, you know, utterly devastated and simultaneously like super motivated. Be better. Funny how the brain works. I also hate climbing. And it's that same sort of simultaneous, like, I hate it because I'm not good at it. So I want to get better at it, so I stop hating it. I feel like that's a big hill to climb. But I'm sure. First time I ever did the Alp climb, altitude Zwift, I came in at like 1 hour 4 seconds. I went into it, I had no idea there was a badge if you got in under an hour, and so I just kind of blindly rode up. Wasn't paying attention to my numbers, nothing. Hit 1 hour 4 seconds. I was pretty happy with that and posted it. to the Facebook group. No, the comments were like, oh, we're 4 seconds away. I'm getting up under an hour. I'm getting that, hidden badge. Oh, it's killer. And I spent the next, you know, however many months chasing an hour up the Alp. And I was coming in at like further, oh, it was getting worse and worse instead of better and better. But I got the lightweights, the wheel set on like my third try. Maybe fourth, I got the gloves, the helmet a couple of times, and then the lightweights. Pretty cool. I heard horror stories about people on their 15th, 16th, 17th attempt, still not having gotten the wheels. Anyways, eventually, I don't remember what attempt it was, but at 55 minutes, somewhere in there. That's super frustrating just to know that, you know, first time up, so close. And I've had this confidence that, oh, okay, well, knowing that there's a badge for 60 minutes, of course, I can get up there faster. I'm just watching it get worse and worse. It's so rough. Not earned the masochist badge yet for going up the Alp 15 or 25 times, I don't know, because I hate climbing. I voluntarily do that, but here I am voluntarily climbing, not even doing the Alp. I do enjoy climbing for this part where when you come off a 8, 9, 10% grade and you're down to 2 or 3 and it feels like you're on flat ground all of a sudden. 10K. 63 left. I got the more famous than Gen Z badge last week. Finally got 100 ride-ons during the ride. Also fun. Hang on to it for 1 year, 3 months. October 2020. Definitely a pandemic pursuit. Pursuit that has stuck. Really hard to imagine not doing this. Javelin helmet. Also just got that. That's a level 37 giveaway. As you can see, not far past level 37. And I only recently learned, in the grand scheme of modeling within Zwift, helmets don't do anything. So here I was thinking that, you know, a javelin helmet would actually make a difference on a race. Yeah, makes sense. Just thinking about how Zwift lets you change your jersey, socks, all of your appearance while you're in the ride, including your helmet. But to change your bike or your wheel set, you have to come to a full and complete stop. I have to assume that they are thinking you're going to make a change to anything that would affect the modeling and how aero or heavy or what your rolling resistance is, if they want you to come to a full and complete stop just like you would if you're in real life. The things that don't make a difference to that, you can change on the fly. So imagine if they ever changed it to where helmets did make a difference, or like a specific helmet made a difference, you would have to stop to change into it. That's my theory. Oh, a little bit of relief and speed. Those are a little interesting. Yeah. Anybody actually cares what's in this, but it's one of my last Kona Cola flavored noon tablets. So caffeinated, actually tastes pretty good. I haven't checked recently, but it was a limited edition at the time. I don't know if that's true, but I'm gonna be pretty sad if I get to this last one. I can't get any more until summer. We'll see. I'll get over it. Not going to be a PR. I'm okay with it. The pretzel does include the radio tower. So find out. Thank you. the legs of toast. A feeling where you feel like you're pushing pretty hard. You know, get your lots. Nope. In theory, after this, I have 10 days of rest, or at least no cycling. Interesting to see how that affects when I come back. Said 5 year old. I hope I'm still cooking up this at 75. 32 minutes. Radio tower. That's what I just ate. Scratch Labs crispy rice cake. 180 calories. Pretty easy to eat. That was strawberry and mallow. They have it without strawberry and I think the chocolate one. I'm not sure. But I've been digging. I'm going to buy more. Look how tiny the shadow is. like something's off there. He didn't need someone for her. Crazy to have been writing 45 minutes. Just barely gone 15K. Not even 10 miles. That'll change, but it's that hard part about gauging how long this will take. A good time to use this power up. Percent grade into the headwind. Crosswinds, I guess. draft. Just kidding. Without competition, right? I have no reason to beat this guy or gal, this writer, but I wanna. Funny trying to get the 100 kilometers an hour badge. Went down this so many times, never got it. I went down the Bologna TT route. Well, first you have to go up. First try on the TT bike. Coming down the Bologna course. Hit 100k. Pretty minimal pedaling too. Calories kick in. He loves Super Tuck. But still, you know, so at 45 minutes or so, it was only 15K in. Now we're at an hour. 21K. Normally in an hour, covered 32K. But obviously not 600 meters of climb. Pretzel. Oh, epic KOM, hilly KOM. Why did I do this? Oh, epic KOM, hilly KOM. Sprint. Sprint reverse. Hilly KOM reverse. Epic KOM reverse. Duh. I have this dream. That was the only hard climb, or only long climb. I don't like the epic KOM reverse. Oh well. I signed up for this. I pay money for this. I'm halfway to what I need to hit my 6,000 miles for the year. I'm 24 kilometers. My 6,000 mile goal for 2021 is great. Let's see, that'll be the... Oh, I guess I'll have 24K left on the route from the pretzel. But it'll be epic KO in reverse. Bye. Weird when the map says stuff like that. Follow. You kind of think it's telling you to follow the pace partner. It must be close, but obviously not. You know, I may stop streaming for a little bit. It's gonna go on forever. You always come back later. Not like I have a ton of viewers. Or I guess, doesn't hurt to just let it go. It says I have one. Ah, so they have three moves. Maybe it's me. Thank you. If you're that one viewer and I'm not on mute, thank you even more. $2,000. And never mind. 2K, I'll be at 28, not 48. Jeez. Looks like B. Brebage, the pace partner. Like a minute back? Okay. Hitch a ride. I guess I was wrong about the pace partner. Dang it. I can't believe I have to do this the other way. An epic KO in reverse. Pretzel. know, real life pretzels are so much better. But I have to say, this one is salty. Just like real life. Yes, there's that. All of a sudden, glad I didn't sign up for the Mega Pretzel. Although it'll be nice to mark that one off eventually. Maybe next December. Still have the Mega Pretzel, the ERL, half and full. Bigfoot Hills, Quatch Quest, and I feel like I'm missing one of the, they're like Three Sisters maybe? Those are the big ones that I haven't hit yet. I see they've added a few more. Legends and Lava and a couple others I'll have to work on this year, or this next year. I'm just putting everything off till next year at this point. Draft when I can get it, or super tough, or both. I wonder if there's any etiquette, and if so, how badly I've broken it around drafting on strangers. Not like it takes anything from them, not like I'm particularly good at it. Racing. Seems like it should be fine. so hard not to go for sprints. I actually have the leaderboard covered up so that I won't do it. I think I'm at my 100-mile weekly goal with 2K linked to this. Must have missed it. Maybe I'm 2K away. Coming up and halfway done with the pretzel. I'm thankful for. Tell you what, I was unable to have Taco Tuesday last night. Looking forward to tacos tonight. Might even have to have a beer with those tacos. Really annoying. I had it somehow figured out. You see one just happened in my graph there, right before the most recent red spike. Done. It was happening, and so I read up on it. It's happening pretty frequently, actually. I read up on it. Got an active USB cable. And I had that plugged into a USB hub. Or I had, rather, a USB hub plugged into a splitter, or an active cable. and two ant plus receivers. I thought I read somewhere one ant, ant plus device. Wait, not making sense. Now I'm thinking about it, not making sense. Whatever. That said, even though it didn't make sense, it worked. Two ant plus receivers, one with the antenna and one just a little key. And seemed to be fixed. Awesome. Then I changed USB hubs to a 7 port because I had some other stuff that I wanted to plug in. And I got a powered USB hub. And at first I was finding I didn't need to plug it in for everything to work, but I started getting dropouts again. So then I plugged it in, still getting dropouts, so I guess it tells me that changing the USB hub to a correct dropouts back into my life. But I like my setup now, other than the dropouts. Life is hard. Hey, we're more than halfway done. Hour and a half. Cycling into it. A little bit like driving, especially when you're going long distances. You find traffic buddies. You end up in, I've done a good pack the other day, just free riding. Pack of like 5 riders. None of us said a word. We just rode. We're taking little holds. Pretty fun. Thank you. guess this is where start the track back to Epic KOM Reverse. Let's see, yep. It hurts already. At least I'm guessing this way doesn't involve radio tower. Okay. What's that? Traffic buddy. Legs are totally fatigued. Like, oh, measly. I'm doing 250, 300 watts. Nope. Barely doing 200. There's a real time, like, perceived effort versus reality gauge. Reverse. carne asada. That's all I'm dreaming of. Carne asada. $30,000 left. $5,400 until I hit 6,000 miles for the year. I don't even know what that is in kilometers. Better at going kilometers to miles than miles to kilometers, but I guess, let's see. Each 1,000 miles would be 1,600 kilometers. Oh, there we go. So, 1,000 and 1,600. Got six of them. Got 32, 54, 9,600 kilometers. 9,600 kilometers. Jeez. Just go 400 more and get 10,000 kilometers, right? That's funny. I would totally do that. Now I'm not wondering how in the world I'm gonna get 400k. Really, make it happen? Thousand kilometers just sounds so good. What 400k is 250 miles? And riding that in 4 days. Let it go, Jason. Degrees in here now. I think when I started it, it's 42, 44, 42, somewhere in there. Fahrenheit. And I have a heater on behind me. And for a while, I was thinking I turned off. My nose is cold. It's actually still running. It's not just my body heat that is. Oh, let's see. Gonna keep up. Bummer. No one's going my way. Steal some draft and make a new friend. I don't feel bad when drafting on somebody who is doing a workout because they can't draft anyways, right? So, all good. All good. Then they change intervals. Oh, they're still going 2.8. Can dig that. The gear. Everything after 48K is gravy. I don't know what I'm going to do to celebrate. I need to break out the caffeinated beverage and have a crispy rice cake. Celebrate my 6,000 miles for the year, 9,600 kilometers. Doesn't sound as good as 10,000 though. I happen to find a way to squeeze in 400 kilometers between now and the end of the year. You bet. I'm gonna do it. 10,000K in a year, so that's pretty sweet. This occasion that I will celebrate all by myself at the base of Epic KOM Reverse. Hey, Hayden. High five. Thumbs up. There it is. Here's up. Break out the Kona Cola. Cheers. Mm. All right, so 15 miles left. Up, up, up. I'll wait till 2 hours on the dot. Have that crispy rice cake. It's the last one too. What timing? It was meant to be. Thank you. Oh, rough shift. Oh, I wanted to take the bypass. It just looks foreboding. Do it, but I'm coming. Almost done. Almost done. At least in 3 minutes, I could have my celebratory rice cake. Oh, 50k. 5/7 of the way. Crispy rice cake. Good stuff. Funny, I feel like I'm watching the mini-map. Doesn't look like I'm moving at all, but I suppose I am. On the profile. Guess I'll know if I hit that little dip. Just because I'm going slow. I'm looking forward to that last little push on the other side. Hell yeah, I did not anticipate this taking quite so long. I knew there was a lot of elevation though. Just figured if mega pretzel takes, you know, 3.5 hours. Had it in my head, this would be significantly less. Still going to be less, but 20k, halfway up, another half an hour, 45 minutes. It's gonna be 6 p.m. and dinner time before I'm done. I'm hungry. I guess I am moving on that mini map, just slow. See that little bit of reprieve after this. Most of what I'm waiting for. Seriously, if anybody's watching this slog, thanks. Usually try to throw out more dad jokes, but I'm a wreck. I just keep coming back to, you know, Zwift. Should make an extra hard version of the pretzel, like pretzel, mega pretzel, uber pretzel. I can call it the salty pretzel. And the salty pretzel in the chat as you're going up just says mean things to you if it's salty. That should be their April Fool's joke this year. See, full of good ideas. Ah, those dropouts. A killer on a hill. Even more killer when you're in a race. I think after the new year, I'm gonna have to kind of start from scratch. Undo this mess of wires and USB accessories. Reconnect and see if I can find some solution. The bummer is that it's not repeatable. As far as I can tell, I'll just be gone. It's a really quick dropout, you can see it in the graph. I think I only had 200 meters of climb left. There's that reprieve. Ouch. Switchback. Mm-hmm. so close. Ah, 300 meters. Last push. Hilarious. This runner is overtaking me. What a way to feel completely useless, huh? I think I'll catch him on the descent, though. Meters past the summit. Pick up. Ah, so close, so close. Competition. Never hurt anybody. Ooh, a fast cadence. Need the PR when it's your first time. In a very long time, huh? Don't need to be going that hard. I just want more downhill. Give me the gravity. Virtual gravity. Thank you. coming up on the last 10 miles. It's quite the route. Having these nightmares of power going out or something. Purge. If you lose connectivity or power goes out or whatever, feel like heard at least what you've done to that point is salvageable with a file. It's written and stored locally. But being close to a route badge still suck. Gravity-assisted kilometers. Although, to be fair, I earned them by going anti-gravity for 20 minutes, so. Feel like going up and down a mountain. Just a harder way to travel. I'm gonna hold up simplicity. Super tough. Almost deployed the draft power up when I saw Mr. Spouse with the arrow. Just cause. But it didn't. Funny, you have your traffic buddies, and then you have your traffic buddies you want to, maybe they're your traffic nemesis. I think the pretzel was 72.9 kilometers. I'm gonna go another 3 or 4 beyond it. So that technically on the day, I've ridden a metric century. I got 24 or 25 this morning. How to do it. This rider must be a bit heavier than me. Not a dig. I admire when people don't have to do this kind of effort downhill. I feel like I get dropped all the time, and I'm not even light. When you run out of water, do you ever just want to chuck the bottle? I lose so many bottles that way. They're right over there in the garage. Nobody gets them for me. Less than 10K. Wonder how annoyed this rider is with me. Don't mean to be annoying, just want to save some energy. Be efficient in the draft. Actually, at 27K this morning. So 73. How to do it? Ooh, that worked out pretty nicely. I'll be done at 7K. Okay, almost there. I have to get my screen capture ready. You know, these long badges, or long routes to get the badge, way more exciting when just starting in Zwift and everything was new. Not that this hasn't been an enjoyable nearly 3 hours. Metric century on the day, I'll have exactly 100 kilometers ridden. Oh. Hit the light, please. Thank you. That's some shared enthusiasm for being almost done. Not really. I'm in charge of the dinner tonight, so every minute here is a minute later that we'll all be eating. Including me. I'm a victim in all this as well. I'm hungry. 4K. And the traffic buddy again. Always good. Also go into the Italian villas. The pleasant part of Watopia. The people that live in the Italian villas, huge cycling fans. In the off season, they Airbnb all of those villas. Sold out, hard to get. People from all over Watopia come in and, you know, just want to see where cycling history is made every day during the ZRL season. Big tourist attraction, mostly. That's a majority of the economy. In the Italian villas section of Watopia. A little known fact. It's also a hotspot for volcanologists. Really the closest that you can get an Airbnb or VRBO to the volcano. Oh, 3K left. That fountain was built to honor both the volcano and cycling. It was built in 1982. Right after that year's Tour de France. Of course, that big eruption in 93 knocked it over, but it was rebuilt. Oh, traffic buddy, don't go. Don't sprint. He's been a tour guide. Nobody wants to hear it. It's fine. Left. Not gonna celebrate the pretzel until I have that banner. Oh, there's the great view of the Watopia volcano. This bridge was actually built 1944, and it withstood the eruption that was built. I don't know if you noticed, a lot of steel, a lot of solid wood harvested from around and in the Titan's Grove region of Autopia. When you build stuff out of quality materials, you know, stands the test of time and has supported many cyclists over the years. It is starting to splinter a little bit, so, you know, people are getting punctures riding over that bridge, and it's on the list of capital improvement projects using some infrastructure funding. So that'll be nice. But don't worry, they're not just gonna pave it. They're going to stay true to the original construction. So it'll retain its character. Oh, 1.5K. These boulders actually were part of that 92 eruption. If I said 93 earlier, I really meant 92. 93 was a different event we'll cover in the future. A lot of basalt in this area from the volcano and eruptions that have happened in the past. Anyways, there's a whole book on it. You should check it out. It's hard to find, though. It's virtually sold out. All right. Coming up on the home stretch here. I'll have to set up for an epic shot. I do have to get to 73K though. Get my even 100 on the day. This will be the pretzel that we're finishing up in 400 meters. Get a good screenshot of the route completion banner. It's always a most nerve-wracking part. It's a little bit better now that you have a progress bar. Never knew if you're actually going to get it or not. This gives a little bit more confidence, but you never know. There you go. The pretzel. I am going to celebrate. Some carne asada tacos and a beer. That's how my virtual bike season ends for 2021. Anybody watching? Anybody watching not on mute? You're incredible, thank you. Have a safe holiday season, safe new year, ride on. Safe travels if you're traveling anywhere. Stay healthy. See you on the virtual tarmac in 2022. Unless I bump into anybody in San Diego, where it is certainly warmer than the 45 degrees in this garage. All right. Peace out. Pedal faster, pedal harder. Visit that website, pedalfaster.club. I make funny things. They're funny to me. They make me laugh, which is mostly why I make them, so that I can buy them. But sometimes other people think they're funny too. Yeah, I have to go to 74 now. But then, I'm stopping. There we go. Oh, all right. Now I only have the mega pretzel left. We'll do that later. Thanks again. Take care, everybody.